12 News' Mike Anderson is a New Orleans native, and he was in the city leading up to the fifth anniversary.
Mike begins a series of reports on Katrina 5 years later, beginning tonight with his personal journey home.
Hello, everyone. I'm coming to you from New Orleans' Third Ward.
5 years ago, I returned to the home where, as a kid, I enjoyed many meals and endured many stern lectures from my parents. After Katrina, I thought no human would ever live in it again. I was wrong. Today, it looks almost new and is occupied. My parents had long moved before Katrina and bought the corner house a few doors down. That house was totally wasted by Katrina, and my parents were displaced. This is home video I recorded when I brought my parents home from an apartment in Marietta, Georgia, to see the house being cleaned out and prepped for demolition. My dad's heart was shattered like the pieces of mementos he saw heading for the dumpster. It was the last image my father would have of his house and his beloved city. He passed away 2 years ago.
Praise the Lord.
Hey, my dear.
Hey!
My mother, Melanise, is on the phone from Carrollton, Texas, on Katrina's fifth anniversary. I asked her if he ever got over it. He did not.
So when he died, he was wanting to go back to
New Orleans.
That's
right. That's what he said just before he fell down on the floor. He said, when we going back home, Mel?
I hooked up with my sister the other day at one of my dad's favorite restaurants.
Even when he passed away, he still had the keys to that front door, you know? So that's how strongly he felt about his home and holding on to that part of his life.
Let me call Beavis. All right.
It's a pity my dad never got a chance to see this, a beautiful new home under construction on that very same lot that he would have had new keys to 5 years after the storm. My mom is rebuilding and planning to move back.
This here is going to be painted in white.
Okay.
And it's going to look good.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's going to look good.
Bill Crispin is my mother's contractor. He has built 50 homes since Katrina and remodeled 100.
Now, all these houses that are built now, they have to be at a certain level. Right?
Yes, they got to be at the FEMA has determined a flood level stage. And from sea level, FEMA, they've come out and once you want to build a house, they'll come out and they'll tag this to say, okay, you need to be at this height right here.
The process of rebuilding is a long and tedious one. That is in large part why recovery in New Orleans is so slow and sporadic. For example, a short walk from my mom's house, I see the location where I got my first job, bagging groceries when I was 12 years old. It has come back, some new and some old businesses in the neighborhood. But on the other hand,
come here, girl. I got to tell my mom I saw you.
The neighbors say,
it's just not the same, though, I know that.
We have only about 20% of the people back that lived in this neighborhood at one time.
It has taken my family, primarily my sister Dolores, 3 years to make my mom's comeback happen.
I had to go to City Hall so many times during a week to get paperwork done, to get different things corrected. It's like each time you take a step forward, there's some obstacle that's confronting you to push you back.
Here's the situation. After Katrina, the government provided victims with shelter and some spending money. The second part of recovery involved getting help to homeowners through a program called Road Homes. But applying for funds and getting them is a whole new hurricane in itself.
There's doors that's being closed in their face, and they don't know what to do about it. So the natural instinct is to get angry, and that's what's going on.
I don't know if the parishes have got something to do with it or where the money's flowing to or when the road home's getting it to the people. Are the people getting it out to fix their home? There's a lot of scenarios.
Part of the funding for my mom's new home comes from Road Homes, part from her insurance, and part from her own life savings. But she is a Christian believer of the strongest kind, and in her words, her help has come straight from the top.
This is what I'm feeling. I'm feeling that God give me this brand new home, and if he give it to me, he must have a reason for me to go back. He must have something for me to do in order to give me a brand new home to live in.
I had to cut her off, but she makes me cry. She talks.
She's making me cry.
Break down in tears. And that's her final answer on that. Her home will probably be done in about 3 weeks.
And how do you feel about her moving back to this new home? It's beautiful, but there's still a lot of work to be done there.
Well, Toya, I have a lot of reservations about that, only because she has made such good friends in Texas, and they just love her over there and want her to stay. And that is something that I know. What I don't know is what life will be like for her without my dad back in New Orleans, if she'll have this, you know, meet the same friends again and have people looking out for her like she has in Texas. But you heard what she said. She's on a mission.
That's right. A mission from above.
She
told us all of us.
Who can argue with that?
Exactly. You know? All right. Well, thank you very much. Tomorrow night at 10 o'clock, Mike's journey home takes him to Xavier University, where President Obama spoke on Sunday. That school was underwater. How it bounced back so quickly and why their neighbors have not.
I got to thank Mike for giving us...